Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I will show you how to create a QA tool with OpenAI, LangChain and Neo4j. So I have spoken a lot about Neo4j and LangChain, and well, this is one of the latest videos I will do in using these technologies. And the final one is going to be how to create a QA tool. No, we are going to use for this case GPT-4 from OpenAI, Neo4j as usual, and LangChain with a chain that had predefined in the LangChain community library, which is Grass-QA chain. So, which in few words facilitate and make our life really, really easy when we want to use these three technologies in together. Well, we can use any LLM in few words. We use GPT-4 in this case just because it's everything is integrated. I don't want to load another one like Llama 3, but we are able to use in this case, for example, others like Mistral or Llama 3 or models through the interface of Llama or other public LLMs. In this case, just for simplicity, I will use GPT-4. Obviously, it's a powerful model, but it's up to you. You want to change the LLM component of the chain for other at your convenience. The way it's gonna work exactly the same. Okay, how it works here? I give you some links. One is about the Grass-QA chain. I think it's that one, if I'm not wrong. So in theory, you can use it not only with Neo4j, you can use it with any graph database. So this template of this chain is designed to first of all understand or make a query to the database, to the graph database, and understand the schema, and secondly create a query in Cypher to translate the query that you formulate in natural language into a Cypher language, execute it, and return back to the user the answer of the question that you formulate in natural language. So, and again, in theory, you can use it with any graph database. I will pass you later on the description the list of suitable graph database that you can use. And also here I pass you the class that is essentially a wrapper of the Neo4j client, and allow you to query the database, to create relationships, whatever it is you can do with the Python driver. This is just simply a wrapper that is included on the Neo4j community library. So in Neo4j, I have created a new project. You need to choose you don't see here on my screen, but you will see it if you connect it to the sandbox. Again, I'm working with the sandbox. It's the easiest way to do this, just not to include more applications in your system. If you want to do it, it's up to you. If you want to do it with the Neo4j desktop, you can do it. By default, come with the movies dataset. That is the one that we are going to use. It's not come to the sandbox, and in the feature datasets, there is one that is movies, and you choose that one and create it. So here I already did, and then you can see here, I have now three. And this is for another video I'm preparing. It's very funny, this one. And you here, you just take later the credentials to access the database. You can do it. you need to pass this to the grapper, to the graph NeoGraph class. You don't need to install the driver because it's already is installed at the time that you install LangChain community. Okay, we import, as we are going to use OpenAI, we import the key and we pass the key to the object, to the class chat OpenAI. We pass the key and we state that the model is going to be GPT-4. We instantiate the client to Neo4j with the URL, the username and the password. We create a template. This is the way that we create templates in LangChain. We cover this several videos on the series that I had on the channel about LangChain. You pass two placeholders. One is the schema. The other one is the question that you are going to formulate to the database. So obviously, the LLM is going to use the information that is hosted in the database. What is not on the database, the model will not be able to answer. This is just an example. Imagine that you had in your company a big dataset. Not only here is just a small example. Even in the movies dataset, there is only few of them. Probably, let me check how many we have. Yeah, I think it's that one. We have only 253 in total, these relationships, and in total in between persons and movie we have 171, meaning that we don't have all the available. This dataset is a subset of the IMDb dataset, and it's obviously not only a really, really small data set in comparison with all the movies and actors that we had on that data set. I think it's possible to do a load of the full data set into Neo4j, but for that process we will need to create a blank sandbox, a blank data set, and import it via CSV. And create it. There is some scripts, I think, I will try to find it and post it as well into the description of the video, and you can play. In that case, you will need to create a database from scratch, and then you will have all that we had available in the IMDb to create more queries, if you want to say, or try with other movies. But in this case, we are going to just make an example, and the LLM and the chain will only answer based on the information that we have on the graph. And here we create the prompt template. This is another class in LangChain. Where using this string with these two placeholders, we have two input variables. One is the schema, and the other one is the question you will formulate. In the schema, the chain will query the graph database in order to understand the nodes and the relationships and attributes that had either relationships and nodes, and looking at the schema, the LLM will build a cipher query, and the chain will execute it into the graph, and it will get an answer. And looking at the answer, and after getting the answer from the database, it will build an answer back to you. And then we create the chain object, the chain object with the class graph cipher QA chain, and with the method from LLM, we pass the LLM. Here again, it can be whatever, the graph that we will use to do the query, and the prompt that we are gonna use to build the query and to return you the answer. And then on here we just execute run. We use the chain object, and using the method run we send a question, and here you have the output. You can do it again, and then you see here we enter on the chain. I put them verbose just to you see the steps that that LAN chain is doing, and then on here you create a query, pass it a cipher query based on the question that you make, and then on the answer that returns the database, which is, you see here, is match person equal Tom Hanks, which acted in a movie M, and then return the count on M, the count of movies, as number of movies, and collect the M title as movie list, and this will return the list of titles of the movies where Tom Hanks acted. This is the context that later passed to GPT-4, and GPT-4 finally build the response that you receive, no? Which is that one. Tom Hanks acted in 12 movies, the list include blah, 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 blah. You can check that, and then on, I think I had somewhere else, but it's nowhere. You can check here, Tom Hanks. You had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 movies. We can count it here if you want. Return count. Oh, no, sorry. This is not added in. 1 second. What I have here? Yeah. Match person, well, let's take that one. Match person. Tom Hanks, correct. Return count. Oops. Here, well, let's set. Here the relationship count, remove the space of, sorry, count R. So we have here 12, and again you can go here, just Tom Hanks here, just we returning the object Tom Hanks, and you can check here the movies. You can check yourself the names of the movies where he acted in. Here now we do the same with Meg Ryan, another actress. And here we have 5 movies. So just a note here, Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan, I know very well that they make more movies than that, but again, the data set that we got in the sandbox is not the full data set, so if we want to know all the movies that they voted, we need to install in a blank sandbox the full IMDb data set, because this is not complete. So but in the data set obviously we have 5. Let's check it. Meg Ryan, yeah, we have it here. So is this person, Meg Ryan, acted in a movie, return count. We can check it out. In here, instead to put Tom Hanks, let's put Meg Ryan. Ryan is a new one. Ryan, exactly. Let's check it. Oops, return, sorry. Return N. We had Meg Ryan, and if you check it here, we have 5 movies on the dataset. Now we can go to do another question. Yeah, how many movies directed Tom Hanks? And count it and tell me the titles. again, you check here how easy is our life, even doing the creating the cipher query, executing and return back to us. And then on, let's check what we have here. No, we have here. Let's check this. Are directed. 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 A movie. Okay. Count R. One. Exactly. So we can go again here. From Hans. From Hans. We expand. So the movie that had directed is That Things You Do. There is no more relations, at least on the dataset. That's Things You Do and One. In which movies Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan, Ryan acted together, and then we got a list of three, Sleeping in Seated, You Got a Mail, yeah, you see here the query, match P1 person with name Tom Hanks acted in movie M, and second person Meg Ryan acting in movie. You see the direction, okay? One all of had to be the same movie, and return the M title. M title is a Sleeping in Seated, You Got a Mail, and Joy vs. Volcom. And we can check, this time I check it on internet, exactly Tom Hanks, Meg Ryan, You Got a Mail, Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan, and Joy vs. The Volcano, Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan as well. Next one is who played in Top Gun. And well, according to the information we had on the database, we had Val Kilmer, Meg Ryan, Tom Selleck, Kelly McGillis, and Tom Cruise, Lechan, and Anthony Edwards. Let's check Top Gun. Yeah, here probably we had Anthony Edwards, Tom Cruise, Mark Kilmer, Kelly McGillis, Tom Selleck, Meg Ryan. Yeah. So again, I wanted to show you how to create the chain using these three technologies and how easy make our life begin. Even we can learn how to create cipher and execute it in a graph database. So it's again, to create a QA with this QA tool with these three technologies is really, really easy. You can change the components and again, another LLM, another graph database, LangChain. You can choose other technology, but as you can see here, yeah, you can get very good outcomes. Let's imagine that you have a company dataset and you want to use it for, I don't know, an ordering tool is backing up with a Neo4j dataset or a transaction database, and you can just use LangChain and an LLM to just query the database without any knowledge even of Neo4j and Cypher language. Okay, that's all. I hope that you like it and find it interesting and educative for your business or for your training or for your personal stuff. And that's all. Thank you very much for watching my videos. Give me a like if you think that is interesting and useful. Subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and share with your colleagues and friends if you think it's interesting as well for them. Thank you very much. Bye bye.